see the endocrinologist today for the follow-up. Just did blood work for him 2 weeks ago. It was an extensive panel. I can't even tell you everything that I tested for, but it was a lot more in depth than the initial one, which was just total testosterone. I think he's doing estradiol, DHT, PSA, IGF-1, all that stuff. So we're going to meet with him now, and heard nothing but great reviews about this guy. And we are going to give you the feedback right after the visit, and I'm going to tell you how I feel and what direction we're going to go from there. All right, just got back from the doctor's visit, and much happier this time around. The doctor was very knowledgeable and just perfect to what I wanted, what I expected out of a hormone therapy doctor. So he wants to not put me on testosterone replacement therapy. He actually wants to do a post-cycle therapy protocol. He feels that my adrenals are completely out of whack. He doesn't know for sure, so we're going to do a diurnal saliva test. So we're going to do a saliva test, which he gave me here. So I'm basically going to do a spit swab in 4 different test tubes, okay, during the day, segregated apart evenly to kind of see my circadian rhythm of cortisol release, because he made some good points with all the stuff I've been through with my father passing, me quitting bodybuilding, potentially taking on family members, whatnot, that my adrenals are probably absolutely skyrocketed. So he wants to see where they're at. So he's doing a test on the cortisol saliva test. And for the post-cycle therapy, he wants to put me on a PCT protocol. And it's gonna basically be HCG at 2500 IUs every other day. A total of 8 injections, clomiphene citrate, 50 milligrams, twice a day for the first 15 days, and then once a day for 30 days thereafter. And then, of course, tamoxifen citrate, which is Novadex, at 20 milligrams a day for 45 days. And then, of course, he will lab test me on day 10 and day 30. He'll do LH, total, and free testosterone, estradiol, and DHT. And he's hoping to get myself pulsing naturally, like I want to be. I would love to be in that 500, 700 range. However, he even said someone did a post-cycle therapy, exactly the protocol I just laid out here, and was up to like 10 or 1,000 to 1,100, which I'd be amazing to get to, because that's like a TRT dose. However, I'm not unrealistic. We will see how I do with that. And my new reading from him, I know I told you guys on the last video that my test was 71 nanograms per deciliter. It is now, actually, it's dropped some, and it looks like it is 57. Went from 71 to 57, so I made no improvement naturally, and I've gotten worse and digressed. Estradiol was 4.1, so that's in the gutter. Obviously, there's no testosterone to convert, so the aromatase activity is not there. LH in the gutter, non-existent. I was very happy to see my PSA was 0.2. Obviously, I need to keep my prostate healthy. He actually suggested that DHEA is not as low as he would have thought. So he says that's a good indication that my adrenals aren't so shot, as my DHEA is not that plummeted. So he was more happy about that. Going forward, I will be picking up my prescription tomorrow for the Clomid, Novadex, and HCG. And I will start that therapy right away and keep you guys posted on how I feel. And if that doesn't work, he's very open and he will put me on a TRT protocol. But this is kind of cool that I'm not resorting to a needle just yet. Well, HCG is a needle, but I might be able to produce on my own, hopefully, with this protocol. And he was very understanding and just a great, great doctor. It was a really good vibe from the start. Exactly what I wanted to feel from the first time. And we're going to go from here, keep you guys posted. And so far, so good. All right. We're gonna head to the gym now. Just got done with the doctor's appointment. And we like to do this thing since we live in Las Vegas and there's tons of gyms everywhere. We Yelp or put on Google Maps, gym, and they locate the nearest Las Vegas Athletic Club or EOS. And 9 times out of 10, it's a place we've never been, so we like to explore new gyms. So we're gonna put on the maps a new place we've never trained at.
Maybe,
I think we should. And we're going to film some back training right now on this 57 nanograms per deciliter test level. See what kind of kick butt training that me and my wife can do, because we're both on the same page. We both have about the same level. It's actually funny. The doctor said that he likes to keep his women around 70 to 90, so a little higher than I am now. So let's see what kind of back training that we can get accomplished here. Here we go. All right, here we are. The Las Vegas Athletic Club that we have not tried yet. So we're going to try to get in a back training workout today and explore this new LVAC that we have not tried yet and check out the equipment and whatnot. And I saw Samurai Sam's as well, teriyaki place.
I don't want to go there.
Though my wife claims she doesn't want to go to, but I've been wanting to go there for a while and see how it compares to teriyaki, boys. So here we go. All right, here is my wife's drink that
you're
she was so adamant that she must have before she trained. And we had to choose the best item for digestion since she's going to be training immediately. And that was something with all protein and maybe a little bit of fruit, no fibrous vegetables or oats or anything that would bog down her stomach. And since it's already been about 3 hours since my last meal, I was smart and brought my meals with me after the doctor. And I'm going to have my pre-workout meal, which is going to be my icon meal of 8 ounces of chicken and asparagus. And I pre-prepped it even cold with sriracha and, of course, cheddar kernel seasoning, so no carbs. And I'm not gonna go over too much because I'll go over it later in my meal plan, but carbs are very low now, so I'm responding slightly better, and I've been very aggressive with my carb drop. So right now I'm gonna eat this. We're gonna hit up some back and film some of my back training upstairs at this new LVAC we haven't been to yet. And then hopefully I'm gonna pull my wife's leg so she'll go to Samurai Sam's, which it's probably not even special. It's probably just your normal mediocre teriyaki place, but I made a big deal out of it, so I'm gonna go try it out and compare it to Teriyaki Boy. And where'd you wanna go after that for you, Rachel?
I don't know, Mexican.
Mexican food? That's gonna be fun for me to watch.
Just got out of the bathroom and I see my friend and client, Stan. So we're gonna get a back training session together, Stan?
Yeah, let's do it.
Guys, Stan from Bulgaria. I helped train him for his first show last summer, which he placed first at, right?
Yeah, that's right.
First place, natural athlete. Look at the guns, look at the triceps. You're
walking. Yeah, this is the biceps, this should be the triceps.
Wow.
Cardio. Just got done training with my client, friend Stan from Bulgaria. Had a nice little back workout. Honestly, with me and my workouts lately, it's honestly just going through the motions. I know it sounds sad, but I don't have a lot of strength and a lot of energy, which should be expected. Especially with my blood test, it showed my hematocrit and my red blood cell count actually fairly low. So my energy is just really in the dumps, but I'm going through the motions. I'm kind of just doing these workouts really just to burn calories and to maintain some type of respectable leanness. Hence why I'm doing cardio 40 minutes a day now. There's my wife in the background who is going through the motions too, but she should be going balls to the wall because she has no excuses, right, Rach?
Not today, but I have been going pretty hard, but not today because we're stuck training with so many people, it's hard.
Yeah, and plus we were training with a couple of people, but yeah, I'm basically just going through the motions and still, you know, having fun just because I love working out, but there's really not a lot of pump to be had. So hopefully after we get on some PCT therapy, and he wanted me to jump up my HCG to 2500 I use every other day, which is a huge bolus amount, so I should probably feel some pretty good stimulating effects from that. And we will definitely keep you posted. But with a surge in LH like that from the HCG, I expect my strength to actually boost up quite rapidly. So I'm excited to see how that goes. And of course, the oncoming weeks, and see how I feel after even 10 days, we're gonna do blood work, see how the PCT does. But all in all, this is very exciting, and hopefully I'll now be on the right path. Tomorrow I pick up my prescription for my Clomid, Novadex, and HCG at 1 p.m. and we will bring you along with us. Then we gotta go find somewhere to eat now. We've arrived to the 3-star place that Rachel keeps on complaining about. Samurai Sam's. I've hyped it up, but it's probably gonna be a letdown. And apparently my wife wants me to get sick from it because I've been griping so much about going here, and she read the reviews and it's not so good. And we got in a little argument, and she said, I hope you get sick from this chicken. I hope this chicken makes you sick. Why would you say that to your husband? So here we are, guys. We're going to enjoy a nice post-workout meal at Samurai Sam's. We'll let you know how it goes.
Oh, I'm not.
But she's not. She has a nice little Mexican dish right there, which we'll reveal here soon. I think Rachel might have went with the tastier choice with this platter here. What is that, Rach?
Shrimp salad with cilantro, lime, and pesto.
So there's just shrimp in there, or are there other protein? Just shrimp only?
No, just a lot of shrimp.
Just a lot of shrimp. That's legit. It's really good. And like a cup full of guacamole. Mm-hmm. Alright, well, you know what? Maybe once I get these hormones leveled out, I can have something like that without storing it to my saddlebags and my muffin top. And here's my meal. 6 ounces of white chicken, added shrimp, and then I added grilled onions or sauteed onions because I love onions. And of course, a medley of different vegetables. I got the sriracha plus a little bit of sweet and sour, which is probably purely fructose, which I shouldn't have, but who cares. And of course, some teriyaki sauce. So here's my Samurai Sam's meal. I'm gonna get to eating it. Of course, Rachel's meal looks better, but that's okay. I can have that once a week on Saturday. And here we are. Samurai Sam's will report my brief summation of what I think of it after I consume it all. Aftermath. Samurai Sam's bowl devoured in 3 minutes probably. Well, Rachel just now finished hers after probably 15 minutes, 20 minutes. It was really good, and I would come here again. And I liked that they customized and added onions and sauteed shrimp and did all that stuff. And that's about it. I think it's a good place. I'm happy we came here. Family time. Every Wednesday, we try to sit down at the couch with our little cat, which is our family. She smokes.
Hey, baby.
There you go. And we try to focus our attention on a show that we're addicted to every week on Wednesday night called American Crime, which we've really liked it because there's a lot of twists to it and it's really enticing. And we just have a little bit of a family time. All the social media, all the electronics that we go through every day, this is like the 1 hour where we're liberated to kind of focus on a show that we like. So
all right.
Here we are, 7 a.m. I got my saliva test kit here. I'm gonna fill up the green tube as well as I can with trying to build up enough saliva. Can't chew any gum. They told me to smell lemons or smell something to make me salivate. So we're gonna fill this green tube up at 7, and then we're going to fill the blue tube up at around noon, fill up the yellow tube around 4 or 5, and the red tube at midnight before bed tonight. Try to get an accurate dural saliva testing going on, then we're gonna send it off first thing tomorrow morning. They gave me a UPS bag, so we're gonna do this right now for the first set. The one superset that I actually feel good stimulation to my triceps. I'm actually getting a pump, and I'm gonna show you. It's just a dip machine, and then we're gonna go over to the assisted pull-up and use it as a close grip bench.
Here we are at my wife's, one of her favorite places, the Nordstrom Cafe. We were out getting some advice from the Apple store. We had, and I got my Icon meal with me. 8 ounces of chicken, asparagus, nothing fun. Well, she has a wonderful looking dessert to start her meal. What's
I should
that?
Have got the coconut.
Red velvet cupcake?
Yeah.
That's just her warm up.
We're gonna show her a delicious meal that she got from the Nordstrom Cafe here whenever it comes while I eat my Icon meals. We're also going to check my bod pod status. We're gonna go find a bod pod and get myself measured. And interestingly enough, to see where my body fat is and my muscle mass, it's probably deteriorated more since my last one. The last one said I was 12% body fat. I wouldn't be surprised if I'm 13% or so. And then we're gonna start the HCG and the Clomid therapy, etc. tomorrow. So I'm gonna bring you along for the bod pod testing here right after we get down our meal, so.
Oh, look at that, what a nice meal she has.
Fruit too.
Garden omelet, a little bit of fruit, a little bit of jam for that beautiful looking toast there. Nice little skillet potatoes. Look at this, oh, yummy. Chicken breast, actually still a little frozen. There's some icicles on there from the freezer. So a little bit of frozen asparagus and frozen chicken. You know, looks about as good as this. They're about equal.
Spinach, tomato.
A little warm up with the red velvet cake there.
Yeah.
Is what I got to deal with. But I do got my Diet Pepsi refill. Yeah,
your
I'm drinking
choice.
Diet Pepsi. My
it's
choice.
All about choices.
Just trying to maintain this 15% body fat on chicken and asparagus. So here we go. Yeah.
We are at Anytime Fitness in Summerlin, getting my bod pod, my body fat test today prior to starting my PCT protocol. And we're gonna see if I've digressed or maintained or improved. I have a feeling that I have digressed, even though just because I'm hormonally deficient. So we're gonna see if I've been spinning my wheels for the last 2 months. Cause I think last time we got it, Rach, was what, 2 months ago?
Yeah.
And I was like 12% body fat. We'll see. I have a feeling hanging around in low T for a prolonged period of time will make me worse. So we're gonna check it out.
For accuracy, just breathe normally and
sure.
Then limit any movement. Okay. We'll talk to you, but you don't feel compelled to talk to us.
I remember, yeah.
Okay, it's gonna be a little cold, but go ahead.
Just flat feet.
Test one in progress. Okay, test one is done.
Go for
two. Do you?
Hold on. How'd it go?
Oh, it's fun. Fun in there. Just got my results back. Talk about depressing. Been busting my butt for 2 months, started cardio, stopped the intermittent fasting, and have been dieting, not cheating, once a week, been having a free meal, but everything else has been spot on, more cardio than I've ever done. And here are the results. I have lost 5 pounds of muscle since the last reading in eight weeks ago. And I have gained 3 pounds of fat. So I've lost 5 pounds of muscle tissue, gained 3 pounds of fat, and I've done more cardio, eaten perfect. When I was intermittent fasting, I was having more cute foods like cheese and wine and junk. Now here's the thing, this is my take from it. It's not that it's a diet issue, because my diet's spot on. Everyone knows I'm not even cheating, even though it doesn't matter, I'm not dieting for a show, but that's how serious I am. This is straight up a hormonal issue. Me hanging out in low testosterone for this prolonged period of time has literally put the brakes on everything. As much as I'm doing, it's just declining it. So this is very interesting. It's very demotivating. I really don't even want to go work out, do my double sessions of cardio. I mean, how pathetic is that? You lost muscle and gained fat, but I'm still going to work my butt off. I'm still going to do it, of course. We started the HCG protocol today, and we're going to see how I test now in 30 days after the HCG, Clomid, and Novadex. However, this is just something that I want to express publicly, that hey, people that have hormonal issues or whatever, this is real,
And I feel for you people. I'm empathetic because you know I'm telling the truth and I haven't messed up on my diet, my cardio, nothing. And you have seen this be halted, my progress just completely be stalled. And the doctor even said I'm climbing an uphill battle. And so calories in, calories out. Oh, well, it says I can burn, or my resting metabolic rate's 3,053. I know darn well I'm eating about 2,300 calories. So the laws of thermodynamics and calories in, calories out does not apply to people that are hormonally imbalanced. You're kind of screwed. No matter about whatever guy that has he's a scientist or a doctor has some accolades or initials next to his name that says, oh no, if it's calories in, calories out, then that's not the end all be all. It's hormonally if you're balanced or not. And I'm obviously imbalanced. So we're going to fix this, but we're going to keep on keeping on. And I might even do another body fat test with the calipers just to get another reference. But we're going to not stop, and we're going to make this HCG the most of it and see what happens. If nothing happens then we'll get on testosterone replacement therapy and roll with it. But I just want to let you guys know the truth. I've gained fat, lost muscle, and I've done more. Pretty lame, pretty demotivating, but we're going to carry on. So, going over my post-cycle therapy prescription I just got from my doctor today, guys. I'm just going to bring out the products and just tell you how I'm going to be taking this from the directions given from the doctor. First, I just have my alcohol swabs with my 1cc 30 gauge insulin needles. I guess I'm a little familiar with these from past experience. We got Nolvidex right here. So take one tablet of Nolvidex a day, 20 milligrams for 45 days. So these are just normal white tablets, not capsules. We got clomiphene citrate, 50 milligram tablets. He wants me to take, so on the prescription it says, take two tablets by mouth for 15 days, so 100 milligrams, then one tablet by mouth for 30 days, 50 milligrams. Not looking forward to this just because it is a estrogen agonist in the brain, so I can be a little emotional. It can cause a little mental distress and ups and downs, roller coaster more than I already have, but this does stimulate luteinizing hormone. So we have right here the bread and butter, looks like the HCG, and it has a cold pack with it right here. It's pretty nice. And here we are, looks like it's a bottle inside of a bottle here. So they want me to do a pretty heavy dosage to initiate things. 2500 IUs every other day for 16 days. So it looks like this. It looks like at least a 20 milliliter bottle or so. 2500 IUs in 1cc. So I have to withdraw all the way, the full cc in the insulin pen, and do it sub-Q is what they want me to do. So subcutaneous. And I'm going to be doing this. I'm going to start this right now. I feel like crap. I want to get the ball rolling. Then they want to test me in 10 days from starting this, and then 30 days. And the doc is very optimistic. He thinks that I can get a kickstart and everything because, as you know, my last test is even lower testosterone. My estrogen was 4, which is gutter low, rock bottom. And another thing that you people maybe you don't know or maybe you do know, estrogen is actually imperative for sex drive, for mood, and also fat loss. A lot of guys are doing it all wrong pre-conscious with the letrozole plus Arimidex, Nolvidex. You need estrogen at an optimal range. In fact, estrogen plays a role in fat loss and breaking down fat or causing lipolysis. This is something that I have a lot of people do, is keep your estrogen in a healthy range, not kill it. I don't believe in some people or coaches that do practice where they crush it, because estrogen basically negates lipoprotein lipase, so LPL, and increases hormone-sensitive lipase. Okay, so that right there is going to increase fat loss and fatty oxidation. Estrogen also triggers growth hormone release. So whenever estrogen's in the gutter with letrozole and aromacin, GH is in the gutter, lipoprotein lipase is dominant, so you're actually blocking fat loss. Anyway, that's that, and I just want to go over that. But estrogen should hopefully bounce back to normal levels, and my testosterone bounce back. I'm going to start this tonight. I'm going to keep you guys posted. We're going to see how everything's going. I'll give you a day by day or whatever overview of how I'm feeling mood wise, sexual function, all that stuff. Just get down to
it. We're gonna talk about that?
Well, not activity, just how I'm feeling mentally. So if I'm feeling like I have a little bit oomph or pep in my step again, we'll go over that. So in my training, maybe I'll get some strength surges from the bolus amount of HCG. I'm looking forward to that. Or maybe nothing. The doctor did say, he said, listen, there's some cases where I had a guy that did use, you know, AAS, GH in the past, off and on. We got his testosterone to natural levels to 1100, which I couldn't believe. And that was off the HCG afterwards. He just stayed at 1100, which is unheard of. Then he said some guys that have used for the last 10 years got nothing from it. And then we're going to have to implement a testosterone plus HCG, co-op together and go from there. So there you have it, guys. There's my prescription. I'm ready to rock, ready to get healthy again and see how I'm doing. And I do get my blood work back in 10 days as well. So we also tested IGF-1, DHT, and other things too. So we will keep you posted.
Gonna go over a recipe tonight that my wife is making using my favorite cow meat, skinny beef, the leanest cow you know, 98% lean from my hometown in Oregon. Well, not hometown, but it's in Oregon. And we're gonna use this and show you how she's gonna make some nice, delicious tacos. And if you're wondering, oh, is Matt gonna eat tacos? Well, I might, because I am only eating about 50 to 60 grams of carbs post-workout, so those tortillas are low fat and organic, and I might include those after post-workout. We'll go over my meal plan later, but yeah, I'm down to about 50 carbs a day just to try to lose this stupid, stubborn fat with everything against me. So she has two pans going. She's gonna get this puppy just going with multitasking here. What's this here? Just a medley of spices, Rach?
I just make taco seasoning, my own taco seasoning.
Cumin, red pepper.
Garlic powder, onion powder, oregano, smoked paprika, red chili flakes.
Nice, and then I cut up all those onions and I'm still watering. My eyes are like recovering, so.
I'm gonna use a little olive oil.
Too.
Okay. So we're just gonna make some taco meat with the 2% lean skinny beef. And once this is cooked, guys, this is 3 pounds, so I'll be able to feast on this regardless of tacos. I'm not really gonna have tacos now. It's just maybe a one-time thing with Rach here, but I'll be able to eat this meat and add it to whatever carbs or vegetables afterwards, just my normal diet food. Look at how red and pure and lean that skinny beef is. It's pretty amazing. So you have to be very careful with how you cook it, because obviously it can dry out from the leanness, but we just want to overcook it. We'll keep a watchful eye on it. And she's adding in so much good seasoning that it's not going to be a problem for the dryness. We made a little last minute decision to add some stewed tomatoes to this mixture. You always do. Well, it was debatable because I was wondering who wanted the carbs, but the carb cut on the entire can is 36 grams of carbs for the entire can you see there, and it's going to be implemented into 3 pounds of skinny beef, so I'll be just okay. And I'm eating mostly protein and vegetables now anyway, so I'll have my carbs post-workout, but that's about it. I'm not worried about the sweet tomato. She's just going to divide the sauce evenly as possible between two pans. And this stuff really is lean, because we drained some just water from it. There's no thick oil or fat residue whatsoever. It's pretty incredible meat. You can do this all through contest prep and treat it almost like chicken breast. The profile is pretty similar. 1 ounce cooked meat's probably about 1.5 grams of fat, very similar to chicken. So kind of a cool little thing to do pre-contest whenever you're sick of chicken and fish and you want like a different flavor and palatability of the red meat without getting the extra fat, which could slow down your progress from higher calories. So, of course, you might not be able to get away with stewed tomatoes, but in actuality, you probably could, because it's really not that big of a deal. What do we got going on after the tomatoes?
Don't encourage people to go off the plan.
No. Well, I mean, if you're enhanced with enough product and you have good genetics, stewed tomatoes won't do a darn thing for you. If you have really crappy genetics and stubborn, then little things like tomatoes and additives will catch up and haunt you. That's just the harsh reality of genetic DNA for certain people. What are we doing? Oh, we're just adding in the spice blend. After the blend here, is that pretty much it, Rach?
Yeah.
All right. There you have it. We'll come back to the finished product here real soon.
Done.
Final product. All mixed together.
simmered, stewed in, marinating, homemade spice blend, stewed tomatoes, and skinny beef, 2% ground beef. Dollars, because I'll be able to do this, like I say, with my vegetable meal, so just protein and veggies, protein using this and then asparagus, and then yeah, I might have a taco post-workout. We got the good tortillas here, organic, low fat, and like I said, I'm only going to do about 50 to 70 grams right now post-workout, and that's it. We're done. Hit up your skinny beef, guys. You can do a lot of cool recipes with them that would otherwise be usually fattening, but keep the fat low.
We've been at the Apple store all day, and Matt thinks that since he can't decide on a place to eat. I know where I want to eat, but we're
Saturday
never,
night cheat meal.
We're never allowed to eat at the same place. So
time to store some body fat.
He thinks that I'm just going to go down one of the, I follow like Best Food Las Vegas. So he thinks I'm just going to like scroll down one of the many food pictures.
I want her to scroll down, close her eyes, and whatever it lands on, we're going to go to that restaurant and just
whether
screw
I like it or not.
Russian roulette.
Okay.
Sounds fun. I could be screwed because it would be like an all fried place and then it'll go instantly to lower
I'm
back.
I'm hoping it's pizza.
Go straight to my lower back. So I could really screw myself with this gamble.
Ready?
Here we go. That was a week.
Oh, and then if I show it, then you can't see it. I didn't even pick anything. How do I pick something?
Oh. Okay. Okay.
Oh.
Oh, fuck. Excuse my language. Oh my god, it has a thing of Cheetos on the cover.
I'm not going here. This is a bad decision.
What the hell? Is this a sandwich place? Mm-hmm. Best Food Las Vegas. It says Snoop Dogg goes there. Okay, guys. That was a lounge. That's not a real restaurant. We're going to do this again. Nope. What's that?
Peruvian.
Peruvian style steak.
Mean Peru.
Okay.
They have lomo saltado, which is my favorite, but this actually looks pretty greasy than we're used to.
Peruvian food, maybe. All right. Well, if we do go there, which if we stay true to our word, then we will update this and keep you guys posted how the food is. Change of plans. We didn't want to go to the Peruvian place. We are at the M buffet, and I'm going to eat some stuff that's probably going to store readily in the fat cells, but I'm okay. Show you some of the food we're getting for round one at the M buffet. Here's what I have. P.F. Chang knockoff lettuce wraps with chicken in the middle. And then, of course, sushi and prime rib. And this is round one. Round two, turkey, candied yams, cocktail sauce with shrimp, chicken jambalaya, white meat, and a roll. Rich cut the crab legs. Round three, more candied yams, pita and hummus. Yeah, I'm having a slice of thin crust pizza. It's fun, I gotta do my body any good. Broccoli and beef, and more chicken lettuce wraps. This is round three, guys. I'm pretty starving. Round four, sushi, scattered sushi leftovers, miso salmon, wheat roll. Rach is on dessert. She's smart. I don't know if I'm gonna go for dessert. I just don't know if I can mentally do it. I don't know if there's going to be any, there's no protein in there, and I'm just kind of a weirdo, and I just don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. However, maybe this cheat meal will potentiate an increase in endogenous test, high fat, somewhat high fat, insulin, lowering sex hormone binding globulin, and now I'm thinking way optimistically, probably won't do a damn thing but store fat, but here we are in round four.